Yeah, indeed, some of the most dramatic video to come out of Irene, at least here in New Hampshire, was in the Plymouth area. I'm sure many of you will remember it was under 6 to 7 feet of water. And while tonight that water is certainly gone, the damage left behind is still being mopped up. It was a short 4 weeks ago this Holderness gas station was completely underwater thanks to Tropical Storm Irene. And a month later, business here is still shut down. Contractors say they've been working tirelessly to finish up repairs, and they hope to see the doors back open in the coming weeks.
We could see the water coming from the fields and from the street, but it was kind of scary.
Nick Holmes is a nearby student at Plymouth State University who showed us the damage done to the inside of his friend's home.
The water actually got up to the porch, but not over the porch, but out back. As you can see, the house is built on a foundation right here, but not out back, so we were lucky.
In Campton, the Blair Bridge is still closed, and that's kept business from this nearby restaurant.
There are dart leagues and pool tournaments and stuff like that happen to be over, maybe at the Elks Lodge across the river. So those people usually stop in here, have something to eat after those things, which we're not getting.
It's been nonstop work for Kerry Benton, who's already reopened his restaurant and hopes to soon reopen his badly damaged function room.
Really been quite a mess as far as the amount of stuff we've had to do, and we're really pushing for time because we're hoping to have it all ready for October 8th, which is our first function back in, which is next weekend.
And in Lincoln, repair crews were back out in the rain, once again working to fix the washed-out bridge to Loon Mountain. While progress across the state is being made, there is still so much left to be done. And weeks later, it's very clear here that businesses are just hoping to finish up those repairs as we head now into the mid-fall season and, of course, the winter season, both of those such big moneymakers for the region. Reporting live in Meredith from our Lakes Region Bureau, Adam Harding, WMUR News 9.